Well, I'm a very proud Irishman, mm-hmm. as Liam Neeson is. And before I start, I want to point out that everybody has forgotten over the last 24 hours that there was a woman raped who sadly passed away, he mentioned, 5 years ago. This incident was 40 years ago. Britain was a very different place to the way it is now, similar to Ireland. I'm not making excuses for what he did.
1979.
Absolutely. What he did,
I mean, hang
was
on.
Wrong.
I was 14 years old then. I don't remember a Britain in 1979 which thought there was...
You weren't in Britain. He wasn't in Britain. He was in Ballymena. You were never in the north of Ireland, were you?
Well, I don't...
Do you know the atmosphere in the north of Ireland? Do you know the way people were brought up in the north of Ireland?
Actually, yes, because I had family members who were there.
He was in a... But he was in a situation where people were dying on a regular basis.
But nobody...
And a Catholic would go out looking for a Protestant.
Fine. I do not remember when it's ever been considered remotely acceptable for a white man to prowl the streets of Northern Ireland.
It's not acceptable.
Wait. The problem is not for a week, not a day or an hour.
I don't think this incident happened in Northern Ireland.
Okay.
I think it happened in Britain, because in Northern Ireland at the time there probably wasn't any.
Well, we don't know where it happened. He won't say, and I think he should say, right? But I don't think it's ever been considered acceptable to do this, right? Mm. Outside of Ku Klux Klan stuff in America in the 50s.
Absolutely.
And here's my problem with it.
But can I just say that we are missing the point here? This whole conversation about whether it took place for an hour or a week and what he was looking out for, the point here is that his intent, yes, was racist. But even more importantly is that his action is representative of the society we live in.
Yep.
That is what we should be talking about. How do we bridge this gap? How do we end this? Because there's so much of this unconscious prejudice that it comes in the form of racism, Islamophobia, anti-Semitism, misogyny, that we see every day. It's a lived reality.
And it's that collective punishment which I think he's highlighted. That's why I think that what John Barnes was saying was trying to commend him for blowing this all open and being honest about it, Richard. But you take a different view.
My thing is this. White people that are watching, don't think that if you have prejudiced views that black people do not know. We're not stupid. We know you might have black friends and you have these views. We know you're racist. We're not stupid, right? So John Barnes, he's my friend, I love him. Mm. But you don't deserve a medal for the fact that you're being honest about something that we already know, right? I mean, we know. And to say that would you say he's not racist for...
I don't believe he's racist.
Okay, so...
I do believe what he did and the actions and the thoughts that he did are racist thoughts. But I don't believe he is a person.
So if I have...
Sorry,
if I have thoughts on raping a woman, does that make me not a rapist?
No, but hold on a second. If you have thoughts of raping a woman, they're very dark thoughts. If you don't...
If you never
act on them, you need to get professional help.
I thought...
Oh, but you don't need professional help for...
And he did. If you listen to that interview,
I thought Liam Neeson yesterday would come out and say, you know what? I said that in the interview for dramatic effect. Of course, I wouldn't have gone out and done it. And when Robin Roberts said to him on Good Morning America, would you actually have carried this out?
He doubled down.
Do you know, I don't actually have a problem with the fact with his candor and the fact that he was being honest. Because quite frankly, we need more transparency around these things. Mm-hmm. This happens on a daily basis. Yes, Liam Neeson has come out and said it, but there are hundreds or probably thousands of people that go out every single day hunting down Muslims, hunting down black people, hunting down to hurt women simply because of our gender. We should be talking about how to deal with this. This conversation and debate of whether or not he's racist or not racist, please, let's just move on.
Racism exists, and his intent was racist.
How do we address this issue in the society we live in?
You asked a question you don't want an answer to.
I do want an answer.
Okay, well, let me answer it. Right, the first thing you're saying is that we should move on. Moving on is not addressing the situation. Right, every time something happens to a black person, it's always, let's move on. It's like, no, let's stay here.
I'm not being rude to you. Okay.
So the bottom line is that one thing that no one has addressed is that he said he felt ashamed for the revengeful act that he was going to carry out. Wait, let me finish. Did he say he was ashamed that he referred to black people as black bees?
No, he didn't.
Thank you. So let me hear your argument on that.
I don't need an argument on that.
No, but that's the point. You're saying let's move on.
The last 24 hours has been spent with the whole world debating whether or not he's racist.
Is that a good thing?
No, no. My point is, yes, it's a good thing.
I think it is
a good thing. But my point is, that is not the solution to the fact that there's probably somebody else on the street about to hurt another black person or a Muslim. How do we deal with this issue?
I'll tell you how.
OK, I would say this to that. I would say that I think we have come a long way in combating racism in this country?
Not really, no.
I think we have. No, I think no, we have.
No, you don't think so? Haven't.
You don't think that this is a more tolerant...
I probably agree on the fact
you
that
don't think Britain's a more tolerant, inclusive country now?
Heck no.
Can I say something here? There's a privilege here. There is a privilege here.
The point is, a lot of the racism we see is probably passed on as casual racism. It's there on the board, you know, in the boardroom. It's there on the high street. It's there on the bus. It exists. Even the comments that we allow the media to continue to perpetuate, it's actually there. So my point is this. How can we address this issue so that we can truly be a more tolerant society? I think Liam Neeson's, this whole experience with Liam Neeson is a teachable moment.
What's the teachable moment, though?
Because...
We're having this conversation.
Because we're having... One, we're
what
having
am I
conversation.
Learning? I didn't
wait,
know last
pay
week.
Pay attention, Piers.
You shouldn't prowl the streets and give a random black
this.
People to kill.
One... It is,
what's the
it's bringing
moment?
About the
Shola's
transparency.
Trying to tell you.
Please don't interrupt me. One, it's bringing about transparency. Two, it's ensuring that we can now start to call out a lot of this bigotry. Call it out for what it is. It exists in our political parties. It exists in the budget. It exists everywhere.
Can I ask you a question? Did you call out Azalea Banks when she turned around and said that Irish people were being quarantined in their own country because they have a genetic gene?
Right, that was disgusting, too.
Did you call her out? Is there a privilege here? All racism is disgusting, but I want to point out that Liam Neeson, over the last 24 hours, because of his honesty, this is not a gotcha moment. This is not a moment where we found out something about Liam Neeson that we didn't know before and he was trying to hide. He's come out and very honestly said this
happened 40
years ago.
To promote his movie. I've done it in a press conference.
No, but hang on. We are human beings. There's a very dark side to people when they suffer from depression, when they suffer from revenge, as he talks about.
Yeah.
There's dark sides to human beings. And if you look at studies in relation to human beings are 7 times more likely than any other mammal to kill each other.
This is the thing. This is the thing that annoys me, is that you always get people that are not of color trying to tell black people how they should react to something that has been said. You're trying to tell us how we should feel about what. No.
But black people are telling the world how we should react.
No. But here's the thing, because we're the ones that were called that.
Yeah.
But you just said. Right, I was fair to you. You just said, was Azalea Banks called out as an Irish person? It hurt you, didn't it?
Well, I personally speaking, no, because I do a talk show and I don't get offended. I'm actually surprised that Piers spent 24
you spoke
hours
up,
on Twitter giving out about Liam Neeson.
You spoke up, rightly so.
For I said what she did was wrong.
You're doing it again. Why are you cutting me? Because you know I'm actually hitting a nerve.
No, I mean,
you stop cutting me then? Because people are not stupid. They can see that. So the bottom line is that you spoke up for Irish people because you knew that they were hurt by what she said, because it was clearly wrong. So when a black person says he was clearly wrong, you're going, oh, it's a bit different. It's like there's no...
It is very different.
How is it different?
Hold on, okay. No, what she did was intentional. She intended to upset people.
Hang on.
He's saying this is something that happened 40 years ago.
Oh, there's a difference.
I don't care.
Well, hang on.
Is that the difference?
No, the difference is, is that he said it was a week in his life where he had dark thoughts.
Wait a minute. I am a 53-year-old, soon to be 54-year-old white man.
The last 24 hours.
I have never had a second in my life where I've wanted to go around the streets.
Have you ever said you want
looking
to kill somebody?
For a random black
have you ever
man
said you want to
kill
somebody?
Well, I haven't. I'm sorry.
I've never done
I'm sorry.
It.
Sorry, but have you anyone said... that does that is a murderous intent.
Okay,
racist.
Well, let me ask you a question. I
Bottom
said on the
line.
Show, on my show recently, that if anybody harmed my partner, if anybody harmed my children,
yeah.
I would get a gun and I would go out and put a bullet in their head.
We stop.
No,
no, no.
I'm glad you said that.
But I wouldn't. But I'm not a murderer. I wouldn't.
I am going to speak right now. Can I just say, those are two different things. Yes, there's a vengeance when someone close to you is hurt, but there's a difference here. He said, and this is why I don't want to get into this whole debate, blah, blah, but let's get into this point. He said, he went out looking for any
Absolutely.
Black man.
Yeah. He was irrational.
That right there, it's not just irrational. It's
racially profiled.
That's beyond irrational.
Richard, speak, please. Listen, guys, speak once.
So you're saying it was racist?
It was racist.
But you don't believe he's racist?
But I don't believe he's racist.
No, but, okay, can we even go back to the fact of, you say, 40 years ago?
Yeah.
I grew up in a time, right, where Roots came on TV in the 80s and the
70s.
Okay.
What a great program.
Okay, we're a great film, right? Okay. We, as young kids at the time that we were, still knew that not all white people were evil. So how is it that we were able to make that judgment at 8, 9 years old, but he in his 20s couldn't make the same judgment?
Do you think the black people during slavery assumed all white people were evil?
No, they didn't.
Black people lived it, and it would tell the difference.
You gave me a prime example of the fact that you're speaking for something you can't understand.
What was the first... Let me ask you this. What really disturbed me about Liam Neeson's revelation was, A, it came in the middle of a press junket to promote a movie in which he's trying to say vengeance is a bad thing. The movie glorifies vengeance, as most of his recent movies have done, Taken and so on. There's a total hypocrisy there. So he's doing this to get headlines, which he's now got, right? But I really despise some of the language that he used and some of his admission of his own thought process. His first thought when with his friend who'd been raped, right? After he said, do you know the person? He said, what colour? What colour? Let me finish. Please let me say what I want to say.
Yeah.
And then he said yesterday, part of his thing, you know, if he'd been Irish or he'd been Lithuanian or whatever, or he'd been British or whatever, right? I would have done the same thing. Nonsense. Because his first question was what's the accent? It was what colour.
The moment she said black, he went out to find any black person that could annoy him enough to justify killing, not just hurting them, murdering them.
If you went to New York where 50% of the population are probably black, it's probably the first question a police officer is going to ask somebody in the event of
a police officer who's trying to identify the culprit.
Are you going to say that in a time where black people are being killed by the police in America right now? You're going to say that?
But you know what it is, it was African American.
The first question you ask somebody is, do you remember what they look like?
Okay. And she identified him as a black man.
And by the way, what if Liam Neeson had said this, my female friend got raped and I was so enraged by what had happened to her, I went out to try and find the person that did
and
it.
And I had murderous intent
and I feel ashamed of the way I felt. I think we would have all agreed, The reason I disagree with John Barnes, who I greatly respect for his campaigning against racism and indeed
he's
for his brilliance as a footballer, the reason I disagree with him about this is that I think he has allowed himself to be used as a defensive pawn.
But it's not just John Barnes.
Liam Neeson only deserves one thing for this. He's not a hero. He's not being courageous. He's done it to flog his movie, and I think he should be roundly condemned.
I don't think he's done it for this.
I think it was an omission on Piers' part. Not on Liam's part, because when he was talking about it, his focus was on the vengeance. He did not realise he was bringing a racist angle into it. I think every part of this story was racist. Yeah, but can I just also say that John Barnes' position was to identify the fact that actually we all have unconscious prejudice.
Yep.
That's what he said. And he was trying to point out that if anything, let's recognize the fact that this man is being honest.
John Barnes lost me when he said that Liam Neeson deserves a medal. Can I tell a quick story, just very briefly?
We've got to bring it to an end.
We've got to leave it.
That's the first stone.
It's a great debate.